Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I decided I would share all of my summer May favorites with you all. Not specifically May, the entire summer actually. And this is not a specific video for makeup at all. This is skincare, makeup, perfume, all of that, everything that I have been loving in these months. So let's get started. So starting with, in no specific order, I'm going to start with skincare because I feel in summer skincare is extremely essential. I'm not sharing my routine in any way. I'm not sharing what I do because I don't really have a routine. I'm just sharing something specifically I love and prefer to use in the summers. So one of those products is this DLCC Rose Water Toner. This is something I discovered out of the blue and I ended up loving a lot. I realized that it does not sting as much as all the other toners in the market. It's not very burning like all the other toners do burn, give a burning sensation to your skin. Even the ones which do not have alcohol in them do burn to some extent, but this little guy over here does not burn at all. It is very cooling, very refreshing, exactly what rose water feels like on the skin, but it's a toner, so it minimizes your pores, gives your skin a very clean and everything that a toner does, but in a very calming, cooling fashion. So it's amazing after I wash my face, when my face is stripped off of all the nutrients and all the gunk. I take a little bit of this on a cotton pad and swipe it across my face and it feels like heaven. So this has been a go-to for me and it's also very affordable, so I love it for that. I'm going to leave shopping links to all of this from Amazon or wherever, Nykaa, whatever I can find in the description section, because all of you are always asked for links. So I've now discovered how to shorten a link and put it in the description because I first did not know how to do that. So the next skincare product is this, which I have absolutely loved and adored. I have actually completely used it up. So I have loved it that much. This is the Body Shop Strawberry Body Yogurt. This smells amazing. It smells like a box of strawberries. It smells delicious. And when you put it on your body, you smell delicious. I love that. I have been using it all over my body. And you get 200ml for $8.45. I actually didn't even know they retailed something this yummy in their store. So I'm definitely going to repurchase this. Why I love it specifically for the summers is because it does not feel sticky, no chip, and moisturizers can be very tricky. My skin has been feeling so dry and flaky in the summers, so it's very tricky to use a moisturizer now, because if I use something which is very hydratingly sticky and creamy, I hate that chip feel on my clothes and in the sweat and all of that. It's not a pretty picture. But with this, it absorbs into the skin so well and hydrates so much that even after 24 hours, when not after 24 hours, but a good 24 hours, you have the moisturization in your skin. This is better than their Body Shop Strawberry Body Lotion, because I have that as well and I have used that in the past. I feel that was not that hydrating at all. That used to lose its moisturization power somewhere between 5 to 6 hours. But this lasts a really, really good time. Even the smell of it, the fragrance lasts for a really good time. So I love this guy over here. This is a must have and a must buy. The next product, I have is the Karma Ayurveda Pure Rose Water Spray Dewy Body Mist and Face and Body Mist. This is 50ml for $275. I think I really, really like this. I bought it like just on one of my hauls from Nykaa and I keep it in my fridge. It does have a very herbal smell to it along with the rose water. It smells very herbally. But I like the refreshing feeling. Like, I like rose water anything. You can literally put rose water in a spray bottle and use that also. But I'm just telling you that I like this Karma Ayurveda as well. And it's not that expensive. $275 is fine because you're not going to end up using the entire thing. Very cooling, very refreshing in the summers. Just spray a little bit of this. And this is a travel size, so you can put it in your purse and keep it for your on-the-go purpose. So that's why I love it. The last skincare item I think I want to share is the Tea Tree Body Shop Anti-Imperfection Solution. This is one of the products which has, I feel, attracted subscribers to my channel, because this video has received so many views, way more than I ever expected, and so many questions. I get daily questions on this video and in my DMs asking if I still use this, if I still like it, how my skin looks after this. How my skin looks is how my skin looks in my other videos. That's how my skin looks now. But I am still using it, definitely. This is like my third bottle and I'm halfway through this as well. I don't use it as regularly as I used to before. I use it regularly for 2 to 3 months, daily, day and night, 2 times a day. But after that, I have made it alternate days, and now very rarely. But I have it and I do still use it. I prefer it more in the night because I think it heals my skin in the night, heals my scar for these like 1 or 2 pimples which pop up every now and then. And apart from that, I like it because it, in the summer specifically, minimizes my pores and does not produce excess sebum. So when I'm going out of the house, I prefer this underneath my sunscreen instead of a moisturizer. I put 2 drops of this and then I put sunscreen because it minimizes my pores, does not let excess sebum get out, does not make me very oily in the summers. Although I am very, very oily skin and I will sweat despite and in spite it. But I still prefer this a lot more over any other moisturizer. I know serum requires a moisturizer over it, but I do not apply moisturizer during the daytime in the summers anymore. I just apply this. So yeah, I'm still using it. I still love it. I still swear by it. So a little bit in the makeup category now. I have been loving and adoring the NYX Liquid Illuminator. I have this. I've had this for a very, very long time and it's not over yet because I use very, very little of it. I don't apply it to my face specifically, but like I lather it over my body. I love, specifically when I'm wearing like short dresses in summer, I love mixing a little bit of this in my body lotion and then applying it on my calves and on my legs, so it gives that shiny feeling on a budget. Like instead of buying Patrick Ta body glow oil, I can just use this with a little bit of moisturizer. So that's why I love it. I am using the NYX Body Illuminator in the shade Pure Gold because I'm dusky skin, so it goes well in with my skin color. The next makeup product is the NYX Total Drop Control Foundation. I have spoken about this in the past. I have a dedicated video for this on my channel. I love the lightweight feel. This is what I'm wearing on my skin now. I bought another bottle in the Nykaa Hot Pink sale because my first one got over. It is very, very tiny for the price you pay. So when it goes on sale, I pick it up for $8.75, which was a decent price for it because I love the formula on this. It's so lightweight, it's so beautiful and finished, so easy to blend and so full coverage. So if you want to go out for parties in the summer, I feel this is a foundation you would prefer because it's full coverage but it's not very heavy. So it's a balance, it's a perfect balance between the two. So I love this. The next product I'm loving is the Sivana Colors blush in the number 08. I've had this blush for quite some time, but I'm specifically using it a lot this summer because this amazing coral color is so beautiful. It's something it's on my cheeks right now. It's very pigmented, but not too much and overbearingly too much. But it gives you a nice flush of color. I love Sivana Colors blush. It's a matte blush and it swatches and looks beautiful on the skin. So if I can find it on Amazon, I will link it below. Otherwise, you can find Sivana Colors in your beauty stores. So that's about the blush I'm loving. Now, the two lipsticks I have been wearing non-stop this summer are the Smashbox liquid lipstick in the shade Bows and the Nykaa Ultra Matte in the shade Diana. Now, the Smashbox lipstick is one of my new favorite reds. Bows is something it's been in my bucket list forever. And this time they had this offer on Smashbox, so I was like, you know what, I am going to buy Bows finally to add it to my makeup collection. So I did that and I do not regret it one bit. It's a very, very nice red. It's a warm red with a blue undertone. It looks very flattering on dusky skin tone. So that's why Superwoman advertises it so much. And I love everything about a Smashbox lipstick. You all know Smashbox is my favorite high-end lipstick company. The liquid lipstick is so comfortable, not drying at all, not very itchy. Love the formula on this, love the doe foot applicator, love everything. Of course, it's expensive, but it's one of my new favorite reds. I do still love Wet n Wild Missy and Fierce. Don't get me wrong, my Wet n Wild Missy and Fierce is dried up. It's completely over, so that's why I'm using this now. And I love this as well. I'm going to buy another Missy and Fierce, okay, so don't get me wrong. The other one, the Nykaa Ultra Matte in Diana, is this beautiful muted pink. I'm loving this for everyday basis. I cannot seem to keep it down. I feel whenever I want to go out, I seem to be grabbing this one. I have never loved pink lipstick ever in my life. Like, I have
before?
I think one of the reasons is because as a child, when I was very little, my sister and my mother used to only have pink lipsticks and I used to only use them and it used to look hideous in my photos as a child. So I never approach pink lipsticks when I have them. Even if I have them, they're only for video's sake, they are never for use. So I don't know, somehow I have this love relationship with this color because it's so muted, it's so nudish, but it's also pink, so it gives you a nice beautiful feminine color, but at the same time it's not very overbearingly pink, you know. So I like that about it. And also that formula is bomb. Okay, that Nykaa Ultra Matte formula is, I don't know what they did with that. Like, there isn't lipstick better than that, okay? I'm saying it. I'm just saying it. There is no lipstick in the market as good as that as of now. I don't know what the other brands are up for, but as of now, that is it. Another product I've been loving for everyday basis is the ColourPop Ultra Glossy Lip in the shade Flying Foxes. It's basically a gloss. It has a mauve undertone to it. ColourPop glosses are very thick, very juicy, but what I like about ColourPop gloss is that they are not plumping. Now, I have really full lips, so if I try to use a plumping gloss, I feel like I'm coming to kick you. So I don't like using the gloss over lipstick because then it will look like I'm coming to get you. I love this bare skin. Like, I'm not using any makeup, nothing. I just put on this gloss, go down for meeting friends or whatever, just like, you know, no makeup, makeup day mascara, and this gloss is it. It looks amazing. It's minimum effort and it has slight color to it, so it's nice and it's very long lasting. And I know glosses are not very preferred by Indian women, but I feel like the gloss trend is coming back with all the brands launching glosses this year. 2019 is going to be the year for glosses, but you won't see much of that on my channel because I don't like glosses that much. I don't like glosses on my lipstick because my lips look like brandstones. Yeah, that's what it looks like. That's true. You know, something apart from makeup and skincare, I have been loving these two perfumes in the summer the most. The first one is the Zara Lip Ad perfume. It smells so refreshing, you guys. If you're in a Zara store, smell this. This is a women's perfume, so it's in the women's section. I love the smell of this. It's so feminine yet fresh, and it smells like lilies but not very overpowering. It's very, very refreshing. I have the travel size because this goes in my college bag. This is something I use when I forget to use perfume, but I love this, and for the summers it's so refreshing. You have to pick this up, and it's very affordable. Zara, this mini size is 550 and the big one is 1000. So Zara perfumes are very affordable, they're just not long lasting enough. That's why I buy the small version, because it will need touch up. If you've used this, you will need touch up. And the other perfume which I apply and go from home this summer is the Davidoff Cool Water. This is the women one. I have loved the Davidoff Cool Water men as well. It's in my cupboard, but somehow this summer I have been using the women one the most. I don't know, I have fallen in love with it all over again. Yeah, I have fallen in love with it all over again. Every time I smell it, every time I try to choose, I have two perfumes with me right now, so every time I try to choose, I'm always going towards the Davidoff because it has the refreshing, romantic, but very muted, but fresh feeling. Last thing I think I want to share with you all for this video is this book I have been loving. This is a Good Vibes, Good Life book. It's written by Vex King, who, if you all know, Kausha Beauty from YouTube. He's her husband, so that's how I know him. But he's also a mind coach, and he's also has an Instagram page where he shares like quotes and life quotes and all of that. So I've known him for a really, really long time. He's an Instagram guru, according to this behind thing. But this book is a lifesaver, y'all. I was going through some real shit in 2019, and this book has really, really been a lifesaver. I have read this, and I continue to read it. I have certain pages bookmarked. I take photos of certain pages which remind me. I highlight things. It's really a mind coach book. Someone who's going through a lot mentally, I think you should invest in this book. I'm going to leave the link to this in the description section. In 2018 and 2019, when I took a break from social media, from YouTube and everything, I was going through some real shit, and this book has really helped me. It's coached me, it's given me certain things to cope with everything that I go through, like anxiety, depression. It just helps you in the most minimum and most effortless way possible. This book helped me, so I hope it helps you all. I hope all of this helps you all. let's end on a happy note. I'm going to leave the links to all of this in the description section. Like I said 100 times in this video, I will see you guys in my next video. If you liked this video, please click the like button. Subscribe to my channel if you're new here. I make videos every Sunday. And I will see you all in the next one. Bye guys. Love you all.